Greetings and welcome, everyone. In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can publicly expose variables inside our blueprints upon spawning them in our level. So let's go ahead and get started. We are using the Blueprint First Person Template Project with starter content enabled. So first thing we're gonna do is create a brand new blueprint. Let's hop over to the Modes panel and the Basic tab. Let's left click and drag an empty actor into our scene. Let's add some components to it in the Details panel here. Click the Add Component button. First thing we're gonna do is add a scene component so we can manipulate the transform of this blueprint that we're gonna be creating. I'm gonna call it the root. And we're gonna add one more component. We're gonna add a static mesh component, like so. Default name is fine. And down in the static mesh section, let's actually assign a static mesh for this. Let's use a shape sphere, like so. And with that, let's turn it into a blueprint so that we can add some script to it. So click the blueprint add script. Let's just call it the sphere blueprint. Hit create. Going to create a brand new blueprint in the content browser and pop open a new tab for us. Let's click that new tab. And we are now inside the blueprint editor here on the viewport tab. First thing we're going to do is create a brand new variable that we can publicly expose on spawn. So let's go ahead and add a new variable. For this example, we're going to call this variable the velocity variable. And you'll see why in a moment. Over in the details panel, I'm going to click the variable type dropdown and change that to a vector. Going to make the variable publicly editable, but we're also going to expose it on spawn. So go ahead and check that as well. Let's compile and hop to the construction script. Now, on the construction script, what we're going to do is hold Control and drag in our static mesh here. Actually, there's one more thing we need to do before I forget. Select our static mesh and turn on Simulate Physics, because physics are fun. So now that physics has been enabled, let's drag off our static mesh now and let's search for physics and see what we get. Got a bunch of options in here. We want to set physics linear velocity. So go ahead and select that and let's connect our construction script like so and take our velocity vector variable here. As you can see, it's asking for a vector. So let's just plug that in by dragging and dropping it on there. And there we go, our blueprint is set. Let's compile and save. And let's go back to the level here. We can kill this instance of our blueprint here. So I'm just gonna select it and hit delete. Over in the modes panel, gonna search for something. Gonna search for the target point because we're gonna use this as a spawn location. So I'm gonna left click and drag that in. I'm gonna pop it up into the world like so, something like that, because that's gonna be cool. Gonna hop to the level blueprint to do this. At the very top, hit the blueprints button and open the level blueprint. And make sure that we still have our target point selected, which we do. So I'm gonna go back to our level blueprint here and right click and create a reference to that target point. Now we did this because we're gonna right click and hit F for an F key. So we did this so that we can get a reference of where we want to spawn our sphere blueprint whenever we press F. So first thing we need to do is actually spawn it. Let's call a spawn actor from class node, like so, and connect it to the pressed. See, it's asking for a transform, so let's provide that from our target point here by getting the actor transform, like so, and let's plug that in, like so. Now, when we select the type of actor to spawn, which is going to be our sphere blueprint, watch what happens to our little node here. Sphere blueprint, and now we can specify a velocity at which to spawn our blueprint. So, for fun, let's right click and say, get random unit. No, that's not it. Why do I always want to do that? It's just random unit. Random unit vector, that's the one we want. And let's multiply that so we get a nice spread out. No, not 8. We want shift 8. Multiply that by a float so we can get a nice spread out radius for our sphere to spawn. I'm going to set that to 500. You can set it to whatever you'd like. And let's plug that in to our velocity like so. And compile. And hop back to the level here. Now when we play and hit F, you can see our sphere is being launched in a velocity that we specified to occur on spawn. So there you go. You've learned how to expose a variable that can be edited on spawn. You can use this for a number of different ways. We could change the material on spawn. We could change the actual static mesh on spawn if we wanted. It's completely up to you and your gameplay needs. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you next time.